Yo, what's up guys, it's Solid007 and today I'm gonna rank all of the maps from Metal Gear Online 2 game. There are a total of 15 maps in order from the original maps to the Gene expansion, Mem expansion and Scene expansion with all of the expansion packs. So yes, there's a total of 15 maps. Bloodbath, Grudge, Nikrat, Urban Ultimatum, Midtown Maelstrom, Ambush LA. Then comes Gene expansion, Copper Dawn Conflict, Tomb of Tunes, Virtuos Vista, and Meme expansion, Forest Firewhite, Winter Warehouse, Stylos Sunset. Then comes the last expansion called Scene, Hazard House, Ravage Riverfront, Outer Outlet, and Icebound Inferno as the last official Metal Gear Online 2 map. So let's get started. I go right in the order with the original ones. The first map would be Bloodbath, a small and crowded map with both above ground, underground options for close to medium battles. I think this is my all-time favorite map, even from any multiplayer game. If you didn't expect that, I think you did, because we have played it a lot in mixes. But yes, this map is like my favorite in any online game shooter. It's very unique, close quality combat situations, and well made for 1v1 and 2v2 as well battles. So I'm gonna rank this map right down there into the S tier, because it's my all-time favorite map from any multiplayer game. Second map will be Grudge-Nikrat, aka GG, the now abandoned weapons factory that housed the Shadow Horde during Operation Snake Eater, contained open areas, offering unobstructed views as well as indoor and rooftop locations. It's good map, it's the one of the original ones as well. But only thing that's a little bit make the map down is its frame rate and lag and registration with the bullets. So that's not going to go right into the S tier or even A. So I'm gonna put it right down the B section tier list. It's well made and well balanced, but the lag and frame, and it's very huge map, kinda puts it a little bit down for me. But remember, this is all my opinions and honest opinions. Next map is Urban Ultimatum. Negotiation buildings of varying height in this urban jungle. This map was remake of the classic map City Under Sights in MGO1. This map is very good, pretty well balanced. Team Snake is very fun in it, and as well as Rescue. Capture in this map is not very good because it's kind of one-sided, as well as bomb mode. But where I'm gonna put this one, I think it's going to be right down the B tier with the GG map, because I think they are both pretty much equals. They're both good maps, one of the better maps. Alright, next map will be Midtown Maelstrom. This Middle Eastern battleground, Battlefield Avenues crisscrossed with alleyways and is based on an area from Act 1 of Metal Gear Solid 4. This is one of my favorite maps, top map on the game, one of the better, clearly. It has nice bases in base mode and bomb sites, Team Sneak and everything is fun, every mode is fun on it. And I used to play this map a lot back on original MGO before I even got fame and good at the game. DDM 990 was classic favorite, playing and opening some noobs. But yeah, this map is one of the better maps, if not top 2, so I'm gonna put it right down with the S tier, there with the BB map. Last original map, Ambush Alley, aka AA, a corner of a war shattered down littered with obstacles, its central intersection branching off into sized streets. This is a very good map, I like it personally a lot. It has nice, well-balanced three kind of lane, like some Call of Duty DLS there's not too much going on. You're always going people behind and can't camp you much. You just need to move, keep moving and trying to get the points and targeting some kills. This is where I'm gonna rank AA map right down into the A tier. It deserves good place right there. Right, so let's move on to the Gene expansion. First map that came with the Gene. CC, Copperton Conflict. City of Sorrow, wide streets and rooftop areas, suitable for close to medium range combat. This map was a remake of the classic map, Brown Down from MGO1. Very well balanced map as well. I like it. Well, probably the best map that comes with the expansion packs, or by far better maps. I would rank this map under the A tier as well with the AA, because CC Capture is one of the best modes and maps in the game. Even though you are kind of get bored of seeing it always on the mixes and streams and videos, but I like it a lot personally because it's just so much fun. And Team Sneaky and Rescue and DDM and all that stuff modes are very good as well on it. So it goes down right there with the A tier. Next map would be TT, Tomb of Tubes, Underground Waterway and Intricate Labyrinth of Combat. I personally don't like this map too much. It's a little bit too dark. It's inside the sewers and kinda not too well balanced. I mean, Team Sneak and Rescue are fun on it, but some modes like Capture or Bomb are not very much, or not too fun, at least for me. Base is fine on it, but kinda one side it can be as well, the other round. But TT I'm gonna rank up right down the D tier. So it's not on the best possible maps on the game, but that's my honest opinion. Personally, what I think. Let's move on to the last map of Gene expansion, Virtuos Vista, VV. South American Power Station, a natural terrain, suitable for medium to long range combat, is what was based on the Power Station in Metal Gear Solid 4. Personally, this is a very important map, even for everybody, because it's a long range combat situation, there's a lot of them. And you can literally snipe there a lot. So that's very important map for the game, because it's the best sniper map in the game. And Team Sneaking and Rescue is also, even though can be a little bit one-sided with that Rescue, when you try to attack, it's hard to attack if the team is hard defending. But yeah, I'm gonna rank VV under the C tier list, because it's a decent map in the game. Not one of the best, but it's decent. Alright, let's move on to the meme expansion. First map, Forest Firelight, FF. Forest Zone, a map with limited visibility and lots of blind spots, suitable for medium range combat. Personally, if you play Capture on this map, it's too easy to go. If you play Team Sneaky on this map, it's hard to attack because you're kind of stuck in the spawn, getting spammed with nades. Not very easy for that mode either, but it's not bad map. I'm gonna rank it up right there with the D, T Dire, alone with the TT. Next map is Winter Warehouse. Abandoned Factory, a three-story building with rooms and connecting passage, suitable for close to medium range combat. That's just not my kind of map. It's three-story building. There's like three different levels, basement, middle and top floor. Three. It's too much, and it's also a very lucky map. Frames per second is very bad on it, and I don't think it's well balanced. Some of the modes are not good on it. Base is fine, and Team Sneaky and Rescue. Rescue can also be a little bit too easy to attack and get the target and wall it, get away. So I'm gonna be honest with you guys, but this is right down goes to the Aftar. It's the worst map in the game in my opinion, honestly. I don't really never liked the map. Next map is going to be Silo Sunset. Nuke Silo, buildings of variety heights and underground passage. Suitable for close to medium range combat. This map was based on the Silo entrance level in Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops. I also did play this map in the Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops online. It was pretty much fun right there as well. This is fine, decent map, but it has like the worst mode ever if you play Capture on it. I mean, some people think Capture SS is the best mode and map, but I personally don't like because everybody goes underground and spams with grenades. It's a lot of nading, too much going on underground. That's why I don't personally like this, that mode, at least on the map. But anyway, this map is pretty good. Team Snake is hard on it because of the too easy small map and getting naded. But I'm gonna rank it up right down to the C tier with VV. Let's move on to the Skeen expansion. The last expansion for the best online game. First map, Hatchard House. The palace, an enormous three-story mansion, suitable for close to medium range combat. It's a nice map because it's something different in like in the mansion, but one thing that was the problem also for this map was it's too laggy and losing frames. But I personally don't think it's one of the better maps in the game. Team Sneak is the best mode on it and it can be fun. Rescue as well. But some modes like Capture or Race can be not very well balanced on it. But I'm gonna rank it right down to the E tier. Because it's one of the not the best maps in the game for my knee. Next map is RR Ravage Riverfront. Clock Tower made up of underground, above ground and other way water ADS. Suitable for medium to long range combat. This is good map. Only thing also in bad in this map is that it's too laggy, losing frames. And it can be a little bit campy because there's the bridge where people used to camp the bridge. But I personally like it. Base is very fun on it. And the tower and some rescue and Team Snake very fun and it on it as well. I'm gonna rank RR right down with the VV and SS to C tier. Next map, Outer Outlet, industrial wasteland made of buildings and underground and underworld. Made of buildings and underground above ground areas suitable for medium to long range combat. It's not bad map. It's fine. Base is the most played or rescue or Team Snake on it. People always host it Outer Outlet with base. There's one thing that's the worst place for frames per second on the PC version, even on the PS3 I've noticed that makes and can even make the game crash. But personally for me it's fine map, but I won't gonna be like it's the one of the better maps. It's just not my type of a map. It's too campy, you can camp the doors and stuff on. I'm gonna rank it right down with the D tier. Okay, last map. Last new official map in the best online game, Icebound Inferno. Aced Snowfield taken from the Comb Tower section of the famous Shadow Moses Island. This map is made of Comb Towers A and B and a vast snowfield in which it is almost impossible to see through the blizzard, suitable for long range combat. This was not included in the original release of the Scene expansion. It was a downloadable the content bonus. So the last map we got in the official game is one of the better maps for me. The only thing, we all know that people some of them like, are the snow blizzard, raining snow, because it's hard to see, but I think it's something cool and make the game a little bit different And then even just Blitzer and Snoke, and it, at the end of the round it goes down so you can see better. But it never really bothered me with them. I could see, sometimes hard to see, but it's fine. And the modes are balanced well. This thing is interesting it because it's harder to see, and base is by far the best mode on this map. And it's very huge map and doesn't even, but it still doesn't lack much, at least for me. I'm gonna rank this map right down with the ATAR on the with the AA and CC. It's a good map. The last map we got. There were also some unrelated maps that Owing the Metal Gear's discontinued and were found, like Desert Duel or Lethal Leviathan, but I'm not gonna rank those because they are not official ones and they are kinda still new and been in development. So yeah. This is the tower list I got into, what happened with me. BB and MM as top maps in the game. I always agreed with this opinion. They are my favorite maps since 2008. ATAR has AA, 3C and II. Better maps as well. Good well balanced map. From close to far range combat, especially on the II map. ATAR has GG and UU. There are fine maps, original ones, that got with the game. ATAR has VV, the best sniper map, or more like the only sniper map we have in the game. SS, fine, good map, but the capture is bad, at least for me and some people. RR, good map. ATAR has DD, VFF, and OO. Not the best maps in the game. And ATAR has HH, Hazard House. Lucky, unbalanced map, not my type. Maybe some people definitely like it, but not me. And the last and the least map in the ATAR is Winter Warhouse. Not just my type. I don't know what were they thinking, but it's too lucky, not well balanced, like I said. Right, thanks for watching, guys. If you want more videos like this, making stuff with the webcam and reactions and talking, thoughts about stuff, anything, I want to grow the channel, not just give you some gameplay from the games, like especially from MGO. I want to do something fresh. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching and hope you like the video. See you later and Happy New Year's.